channel, yes it did, to do a show that's nostalgic for the 2000s kid. Now he's got new subscribers and for Tuesday's getting big.
It's Drew's View.
Drew's View. Now if you tune in, you might be in for a big surprise. He doesn't get excited and his humor is real dry, but he pays close attention and he tries to analyze.
Drew's View.
Stop as the Ben fans say that he's the baddest reactor to ever make their day.
Drew's View.
Did it true? Drew's View. Did it true?
Hey, we got Drew's Views here, and I'm back for a little Car Tuesday, reacting to cartoons on Tuesday. You already know it's Ben 10, Alien Force today, Season 1, Episode 11, 1-1. So last time on, we had quite the paradox. Unfortunately, I'm having to film this episode quicker than I normally do. I usually do like space them out a week, look at the comments, all that type of stuff, think about the last episode a little bit. Couldn't do it this time, so unfortunately that one's coming out tomorrow as of when I'm recording this. So looking forward to the comments on that and seeing what's going on, telling me what I missed or anything like that. But yeah, I don't have that available right now, but from what I remember, the Paradox guy, I think that was just what they were calling him. They didn't say what his real name was. He'd been stuck in time. He went mad and then he went sane again. Knew everything. He alluded to working with future Ben. Of course, yeah, it was the whole time travel thing of like, where in time is this right now? This happened already, blah, blah, blah. But Kevin got turned into an old man at one part, as did his whip. Luckily for him, they both got turned back to normal at the end. Yeah, the ride ended up being back to fresh off the assembly line, so yeah. But yeah, there was that like monstery thing, which turned out to actually be the guy's assistant trapped in there, but that was causing the problems in this kind of abandoned town, Cold War vibe town. Yeah, I really liked the setting last time, and the Paradox guy was pretty funny too. I like that sort of character with that kind of removed attitude from being so above everything how it is now. But yeah, Ben was the one to figure it out, not the guy though, so yeah. Maybe it was too close to the situation. Anyway, I don't know if we'll see that guy again. Certainly not this time, I wouldn't think, but it would be cool to see him in the future. Anyway though, this one's called Be Knighted. KN Knighted. So I'm thinking we might be back with our old friends, the Forever Knights here. I'll be surprised if we're not with this title. And given that Kevin still kind of works for them, or he was at the beginning of the season at least, making deals with them. I guess doesn't work for them, but works with them, so who knows if they'll be involved. I mean, they were also trading with the DN aliens, which I'm at the beginning of the season, although possibly they didn't know it was them, I guess, because they were disguised, the aliens, but yeah, I wonder if that's going to come up. I am looking for the DN alien plotline to ramp back up here with only 3 episodes left in the season. So we'll certainly see, at least I will, right now, when I get into the damn episode. Let's do it. Well, 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 I think that's gonna continue the Feather Knight's story then, as it pertains to Ben and co. Obviously there are pictures there, like I just mentioned, and that Squire kid didn't seem happy about it. Probably feels guilty, maybe he'll warn them or something. I don't think this is gonna continue like next episode, because again, the DNA aliens weren't even part of this one again either, and I gotta imagine they're in the finale at least, if not the last two. But yeah, maybe next season or down the line, get more Forever Knight stuff. So they were started because of that dragon in the first place 1,000 years ago. And then at the end, they're just basically justifying their existence, the Patrick guy, the king, whatever, saying like, oh, now there's a bunch of them, even though it's not what we thought. They'll want revenge, or, you know, we still need to exist. Don't worry. It's almost like, I don't know, like a lot of religions or like anything where they're like something didn't happen, or like they're predicting the end of the world or something and it didn't happen. Oh, wait, now actually this tells me that it's going to be in this year or whatever. So kind of in that type of vein, I think. And there's a lot of knights in there, I guess. So yeah, and then with the Connor guy, you know, of course he wants to, that taking the oath, the whole thing about knights taking oaths and all that. It's like, that's the only thing then, no matter if it makes sense or not, that's the only purpose. So yeah, interesting. Yeah, glad to have the knights back though. There was interesting too that they were gonna work with Ben initially, even though they're just using him, but still it wasn't like they're actively trying to. They were fine with him getting hurt or killed or whatever, but they weren't actively bringing him in to try to trap him or something. I guess they don't really care about him anymore necessarily, unless he can help them in their goals. Until now, maybe they are back. Ben, Gwen, and Kevin are back on the enemy list here. I mean, I would think that would have been anyway from how the original series ended, but guess different management or whatever, possibly. I'm trying to even think now. Well, you can tell me in the comments, yeah, how it ended again, or none of these characters we saw this time were in the old series, right? So yeah, we had more of the stuff of Gwen telling Ben, you know, about the using your head stuff, but that came out throughout the first series as well, things like that. Was Ben using his head with what he did at that? And he was appealing to the, I guess he was, I mean, he was appealing to the dragon's sense of, like, being the bigger person or whatever, as the math maker, not a monster. But yeah, I could definitely see the wanting revenge, even though we don't know exactly how long it's been with the dragon years. He said like his kid might be have wings now or be flying now or whatever. But and as usual, everyone's just an alien. There is no just regular non-alien dragon. It was interesting the whole time, like, you seeing like the dichotomy between like the Forever Knights have all the technology, but they're still knights fighting the dragon, and then like the planes in the sky with the dragon and all that, and the knights looking on the computer. It is funny contrast that you obviously don't see too often in the media. Yeah, good episode though. Yeah, like I said, I'm glad to have that plot line opening back up, seemingly, of those antagonist group. Anyway, that should do it for this one. Do join me back for the penultimate Season 1 Alien Force episode next Car Tuesday. Of course, leave the comments. Get the conversation going with each other. Subscribe if you're not already. Like, etc., etc. But until then, I'll be up out of here. Peace.
This day is over!